Central Coast and across the country, public events mark today's National Day of Prayer, a government-sanctioned event that was passed by Congress in 1952 and signed into law by President Truman.
How you doing? God bless you.
In Watsonville this afternoon, dozens gathered at City Plaza to observe Prayer Day, despite a federal judge's ruling last month that the day is actually unconstitutional. More on the controversy tonight from Action News reporter Mae Chow, live in Salinas.
Well, Dan, many who believe in the power of prayer, no matter their religion, observe National Prayer Day, and church leaders in Watsonville decided to take this day to address the problems plaguing their community. The mission Thursday for pastors and ministers in Watsonville to spread peace and unity in their community through the power of prayer.
All 54 of the churches involved in the city to seek the answers for the violence and the sin in the city from God. We have a biblical worldview. We don't have a worldview. People talk about politics and whatnot and the White House and all that. We're commanded to pray for the White House.
Praying for you. God bless you, man.
Pastor Bruce Rivers of New Birth Baptist Church helped organize a day-long observance of National Prayer Day. The event allowed people to express their freedom of religion and to come together as a community to address gang violence in their neighborhoods.
The police and fire department and parks and rec in the city could only do so much. And the pastors and the ministers, they touched the hearts of thousands of people in their congregations.
And those who came to Thursday's vigil say prayer is much needed in Watsonville.
Amen.
I think we need it desperately, and we need his healing touch on all aspects of our lives.
I believe that God's going to do something in Watsonville, and he's going to shake the ground, and things are going to change for Watsonville.
A change, Councilman Greg Happett says, will start slow, but eventually gain momentum.
They're declaring peace in Watsonville. And they've been praying over the map of the city every week. And they're going to start going out block by block and praying in each neighborhood in the city.
Caput says his main goal is to reach out to families and teens who may be drawn into gangs and work toward not only peace on the streets, but also a peace of mind.
We all want the same things in life. I think basically we want a safe community to live in. We want good schools for our children.
The National Day of Prayer Vigil in Watsonville goes until 7 tonight, and they also hold prayer vigils every Thursday, the first Thursday of every month. Dan?
All right. Thanks very much, Mae. President Obama issued a proclamation for this year's National Day of Prayer, less than 3 weeks after a U.S. District Judge ruled that event unconstitutional.